Hello, I'm Sandy Ingram, your news coordinator for all things exotic currency and U.S. taxes. In this video, I will share with you information surrounding the question of devaluation of the Iraqi dinar. They had a meeting. They came to a conclusion on whether or not to devalue the IQD. Also, there is a new business registration process that makes going into business in Iraq 100 times easier. I will share the details of this new process. OPEC increases oil production limits with the second wave of the pandemic, crushing oil prices, plus foreign currency exchange rates. Okay, here is the news we've all been waiting for. In this article, we learned that on October 13th, Iraq's Council of Ministers endorsed the white paper for financial and fiscal reform. The paper, a first for any Iraqi government, identifies the fault lines in the economy and the political system that supports these fault lines. The financial reform, more than any other action, says the Iraqi government understands the financial problems they are suffering during the pandemic. The new president says there is less denial now, whereas before there was complete denial. The article goes on to say, while a devaluation is seen by the political elite as the preferred solution for stretching the state's diminishing oil revenues to cover its expenditures, especially the payments of salaries and pensions, the paper argues that this would ultimately increase the prices for goods and services, thus increasing the cost of living in Iraq. Now, this would cripple the country's 40.2 million citizens. So it looks like they have decided the devaluation is on hold, at least for now. There is a completely new online single window system to register your new business in Iraq. Iraq is making an effort to catch up with the high-tech world when it comes to business. Opening a business in Baghdad has never been easy. All you need is one dream, one form, and one payment to complete the entire administrative side of establishing operations. This new process simplifies a process that took dozens of separate steps and multiple in-person visits. Now, all it takes is a few clicks and you're in business in Iraq. Oil prices are crashing due to the second COVID-19 wave. OPEC productions increased significantly last month. Iraq and Nigeria are once again reneging on pledges to lower their shipments. Iraq needs income in order to keep the government functioning during the recent OPEC policies to cut oil productions. Baghdad boosted supply by 160,000 barrels a day to a total of 3.87 million barrels a day, while the UAE trimmed its production down to 100,000 barrels. In this article, which is a credible media source, they actually call OPEC a cartel. The link to this entire article is in the description. Now, let's communicate the foreign currency exchange rates for several of our favorite exotic currencies. It only takes one of these currencies to greatly increase in value in order for investors to realize a significant profit.